Sharia. So the worst we give for Allah. True or not? It's a fact. Instead of saying, this is the smartest one of among my children, I want him to become the alim. So this is what we should do. And inshallah, your father will work hard to make you alim. Amen.
Jazakallah, brother. Inshallah, I'll become an alim.
Inshallah. Amen.
Acceptable to read the Quran in English or in any language that you know. Will Allah be upset if you do not know Arabic?
Reading it.
Reading the translation,
you mean? The tafsir, or reading it in the salah?
Can you explain that?
I don't know what it was.
Reading the Quran in English.
You mean just the translation you read and you don't read the Arabic?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Inshallah, no doubt you will get the reward. But don't forget you are reading translation, you are not reading the Quran. What you are reading only translation. You are not reading the Quran. Because the Quran is the word of Allah. So you are only reading the rough meaning of the words in general. You are not reading Quran. You are reading translation. But the translation, they help, no doubt. You get tafsir on your mother tongue, they help you. They give you know, idea. But if you want to go and start enjoying the Quran, and see the sweetness of the Quran, you need to know the Arabic language. Then you will start really enjoying reading the Quran and reading the books of the tafsir, etc. Translation, something better than nothing. Okay? But I encourage every brother and sister to learn Arabic. Learn Arabic. That is the tool, the key of understanding the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam.
Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh. My name is Sayyid Zakir Ahmed, and I have never asked this question before. I will talk for 2 minutes and then the question.
You be brief, please.
Jazakallah.
It should not be a difficult question.
Eh? Yeah, it should not.
We have more people.
Inshallah. I feel very comfortable talking today. The first time I'm posing a question, being the organizer of this event, your lecture today shook me up. Alhamdulillah. 60 years of calculation. Tell me, brother. We are all doing business. I am talking on behalf of a lot of business people here who probably are ashamed or rather guilty or rather feeling nervous to come to the mic and talk. That's why I said I am talking for the first time on their behalf. We can really spare not 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. Probably we can even at this age join an Arabic college, do tajweed. I'm sure we can. But we are in the midst of competitiveness. And, you know, this, you get caught in a business, you know, you're galloping. You suddenly stop. You are totally out. You know, you can't even feed your family. My question is, should we reduce our business gradually, come to a point where we see enough, what mistakes we have done, where we started galloping, now we reduce, we don't expand further, we contain ourselves with whatever money we have, doesn't matter about the future of the children, Allah Ta'ala will take care, and cut down all the projects, instead of working 18 hours, 20 hours, instead of working 7 days a week, we cut down to 8 hours a week, 8 hours a day, and 5 days a week. That will definitely affect the business. Also, it will go down. Is that the right way? Or because we need peace of mind to do this tajweed, you know, to go to Arabic classes. We need peace of mind. You cannot go to a Tajweed class or an Arabic class calculating what's the bank balance tomorrow, a post-dated check which I issued will come, the sales tax matters. All this you cannot really go to concentrate. So the best way what I realized after your speech was, either I go back to my office maybe tomorrow and tell my team, boys, I'm cutting down on my projects. I'm not doing 16 projects a year. I'm doing only 2 or 3 projects a year. For me, alhamdulillah, 10,000 rupees per month is enough. I'll take care of my family. So I'm reducing my projects. Is this the right way? Or how should I go about reducing my burden, my tension, to follow the dini classes, to do a lot of, Quran, you know, I can do Quran, of course, I can do probably one para, one page, you know, for the sake of doing, but that's not what you say. We should do it from the heart. So that takes a lot of guts. I'm talking to all the business people here. I'm talking to all the business people who are seated here. Realize, because we come, we listen to lectures. I'm making it a little bit more questionable, because probably being the organizer, I have taken the guts to talk like this on behalf of all the people seated here. I just want you to throw some light, brother. Tell the brothers, cut down on your work. 3 times a meal is enough. Just limited earning. Concentrate on your Quran and Sunnah. That's it.